So I got a vasectomy during one of the lockdowns that made sure I never want to parent again.
We sort of became like a commune of hillbillies.
There were just these long periods where you couldn't hand over the parenting to some other kind person who you're paying.
Clothes were optional, pants were optional, getting dressed at all was optional. I just decided very early on not to sweat the small stuff.
Of course I don't have a favourite child. Like, they can watch this, right?
I like a lot of things about child number one and a lot of things about child number two, but I like them both.
Yeah, you always have a favourite child, but it changes.
I'm not going to answer that, am I?
Lewis, who's the eldest, but because I've known him the longest, like, the more that I know you all, the more that I love you.
My favourite child is the one who cleans up after itself. So if you want Daddy to love you more, clean up your stuff.
I mean, you know who you are.
Going on the project, taking my shirt off to show a tattoo, that didn't go down all that well with them. One of my daughters plays AFLW. I said on the project that I didn't think anyone would cross the street to watch it.
How many times in the early years of parenthood I went on stage and talked about how much I hate my kids? Could that be it?
You can't be perfect. Just embrace being pretty average.
With teenage girls, just relax. It takes a while, but at the end of it all, a butterfly emerges.
Some of the best advice that I've had is that if the kids are squabbling, let them work it out themselves. Don't jump in as the umpire, because you'll never win.
Wear goggles when changing your son's nappy, because they piss in your face.
You have a moment where you think, oh, my goodness, I've really nailed this, and then the rug completely gets pulled.
Your politics are probably different, so we don't talk politics.
I think the worst advice I had of parenting was children should be seen and not heard, and that advice came from my father. That kind of advice turns an adult into someone who only feels love when they get appraisal from strangers, like a stand-up comedian.
That a baby should feed, then play, then sleep. That's the order you're meant to do it in, right? Did you know that babies don't care about rules?
Absolutely. Like, I'd prefer to be waterboarded. I'd prefer to have my fingernails pulled out.
10 minutes in, snatched a pencil out of her hand and snapped it in half and walked out. Like, that's how hard remote learning was in our house.
That was a horrible experiment that I hope we never have to repeat again.
I remember my daughter said to me, she said, oh, Mum, I really want to get my ears pierced. And I said, sure, I'll take you down on Saturday. And that was it. For me, it was a 15-year struggle. And against my mum, who nonsensically made up rules about what I could do with my own ears.
I set rules, which I then break myself. I have no consistency in my parenting. You just do what it takes to get through the day.
Yeah, I'm an easy touch, very easy touch. One phone call from one of them, pretty much they can have what they want.
My method of parenting is to keep them all on a knife edge of uncertainty. You know what I mean? Tuck them in at night and go, you're adopted. Sleep well.
There were some long days in Italy, I think.
Okay. I think so. I was trying so hard to listen to all of that, but when we got to that footage of Steve Price and his tat,
yes.
I've never seen that before. I can't unsee it.
Yeah, and under his shirt are some confronting fluffy bunnies that I did not
as well.
Need to see.
Yeah. What does DS stand
Dane
for?
Dane Swan. He was in this. I'm a Celebrity with Me in the Jungle. Yeah. And if he got out after Dane or before Dane, he had to get the.
Oh, I can't believe it stood for something else.
Mm. I can't believe Price named his kids Child 1 and Child 2.
Yeah.